Ironically, Patrick Roy in this game faces a team that he has had some troubles against in his career, as he has won only 10 games against them and lost that many as well. So Patrick Roy tonight against the Washington Capitals will try and put one away that'll make him number one all time, going for number 448.
He's actually only won two games in his career here in Washington, whether it be here at the MCI Center. He's 0-1 here. His two wins came at the old Cap Center, the US Air Arena, so not a friendly place for Patrick Roy.
And the Washington Capitals have not won a game. Let's not lose sight of what they've got at stake here tonight. They have barely been hearing it from Ron Wilson, their head coach, for the last 2 days. They have lost three and tied two games here at home. They've played only one game and lost that one. While the Avs are off to a good start, they haven't lost a game. They are 3-0-2, so exactly the opposite records going against one another here tonight. Shot on Roy, that'll be his first save, deflected away off James Black's chance in the corner. Halperin turning with it. Halperin trying to set it up along the near side wall. Black will dump it back in behind the net. Joe Sacco on this line. Left it again back in behind the net, loose, chased down by John Klemm of the Avs. Klemm got it up the boards, could not get it out of the zone. Black was there to hold it in. Shot deflected off Roy's left pad, and he'll hang on to that one. For Patrick Roy, is there pressure as he approaches this all-time record? Listen to the words and look at the face.
Pressure, and if it's not tonight, then it'll be the next game, and if it's not the next game, the following. I mean, I don't feel any pressure, and I don't want to feel any pressure off that one. I just want to go out there and have a lot of fun, and especially not put pressure on my teammates.
Easier said than done for any athlete. Patrick Roy is one of those guys that can actually say, listen, I do not want to feel pressure, I want to have fun, and well, we know him well enough to know that he's out there having fun.
Deadmarsh over to Sakic, who got ridden out of the play after he tipped the puck near side. A lot of times when you get to this point in a career where you're looking for this kind of a record, it's near the end of someone's career, and the chances may not be many. Score! A deflection and a shot by Tanguay! That went off a body butt for Olaf Kolzig at the other end. Looked like he had plenty of time to see that, and didn't look like he even touched it.
No, and Olaf Kolzig is coming off a weekend where he played his first two games of the season, back-to-backers. I talked to him before the game. He said, I'm playing well. I'm happy with what I'm doing. It'll be interesting to see if this is deflected. But the Capitals may have dug themselves a hole here right away. And I'll tell you why. That wasn't deflected, was it? It was a partial screen. But now Kolzig, see him? He's looking down at his pad here to see where this thing went wrong. He looked immediately down at his pads. Alex Tanguay launched a pretty good one, but that was a stoppable shot. Now here we go. The Washington Capitals have not led at any point in the hockey season yet, and they're behind here in period one.
They have given up now 9 goals in the first period and scored only one. Poke checked away by DeVries. Good play by DeVries in the corner on Richard Zednik. Zednik, who's got 1 goal on the season. They try and pump it up right here. Lost in behind the net by Elf Dahlin. Dahlin checked off the play. Came loose. Zednik near side. Zednik leaves for Dahlin. Dahlin behind the net will get help. Jan Bulis, the center on this line, the 22-year-old, held it in off the near side wall up. Joe Rieke banging for it. Couldn't get it. And it rolls back out the center. So the goal picked up by Tanguay will be his first of the season. Adam Foote gets the assist. 1:11 the time of the goal, and it didn't take long for the Colorado Avalanche to put that one home. The Avs are averaging 2.8 goals a year, the cap per game rather. Caps giving up twice as many as they have scored so far, and for Ron Wilson, oh my gosh, here it goes again.
Well, I mentioned them digging a hole. It's only 1-0, but when you understand that his team has yet to lead in any game this season, the hole is dug mentally when you're sitting on the bench saying, man, here we go again, and we're going to have to play from behind. And that really backs the Capitals into a corner because they have trouble scoring goals. Yes, Peter Bondra is here. He's asked to be traded. He's been ineffective. They don't have many guys that can put the puck away, so coming back is difficult for this team.
Capitals with 2 shots. The Avalanche scored on their very first chance. Olaf Kolzig gets a Bronx cheer from the home crowd. 30-year-old netminder, as Bill said, in just his 3rd game. He came back in a hurry after injuries. Fireside picked up by Peter Bondra. That's the man who said he wants to be traded and is expected to be. Miller back to get it. Rolled right in on Patrick Roy on that deflection, but he knocked it away with a stick. Avalanche will turn that one back out to center. Avs are a tough team to play on when they get a lead because they'll open it up even more. Ken Clay in the corner had it, lost it. That banged up in the air to the near side off Nikolajan's stick. Held in by Milan Hajduk. Hajduk getting help down low from Dingman. Chris Dingman centered shot, and that one may have gone off the end of the glove or just a little bit wide. Dumped back down deep by Aaron Miller. Colorado keeping the heat on here. Here's Sakic with it. Sakic looking out in front. Everybody jamming the crease. Sakic waiting. Comes around himself. Centered. Rolled in. Shot. Deflected off the side of the net. Good setup by Joe Sakic down low. Sakic had all of that one. Washington will take a pin up here if they can get it for a whistle. They need a line change, and they've not been able to move the puck out of the zone. It's just run along the wall. Klee was there, couldn't get a handle on it. Played deeper by Sean Podine. Podine tried to leave it, knocked away by Miller and clear.
Well, finally, the Caps will get a chance to change. The Sakic line was able to get out there one by one and trap the Nikolajan line for Washington on the ice. And boy, you talk about some dead humans. That's what Washington had in their own zone.
And Martin Skula, the 20-year-old, came back to get it. Left in the corner, the veteran, Kalle Johansson over. Johansson leads the team in points with 4, 1 goal, 3 assists on the year for Johansson. But that doesn't say much because the Caps are averaging a goal and a half a game in their first 5 games. Hard to win. Out. Adam Foote out to get it. Foote leaves it back. Scratches tonight. Nolan Pratt, Alexei Guthrov, and Dan Hynote for Colorado. Dmitry Mironov, Chris Beach, and Glenn Metropolitis out of there for the Washington Capitals. Back around the fireside. Great to have you with us this historic night as Patrick Waugh. Family members on hand will show you later the opportunity to become the winningest goaltender ever. National Hockey League, Gary Bettman is on here and here tonight as well. If he can get that win tonight, there will be some ceremonies. We'll show you all of that depending on Patrick Waugh and Colorado coming away with a win. That's touched up for the icing call. Told you there were family members on hand. There is Michelle, Patrick's wife. His dad is also on hand here. Patrick's dad is also named Michelle. He's on hand. The kids aren't here tonight.
None named Michelle.
No, none named Michelle.
Pretty name, though.
Cleared back out. Connor Walchuk's got it. Connor Walchuk jammed that one ahead. Raymond Bork. Bork's going to play less this year. Yeah, right. 31 minutes, 19 seconds a game for Raymond Bork through the first 5 that have been played by Colorado.
Isn't that down about 4 seconds
yeah,
per game, though?
Yeah, we'll see. That's exactly what he meant when he said, I think I'll play less this year. 4 seconds a game, but he'll probably make up for that after the All-Star break. Avs continue with the heat. Shot, save made. Rebound clipped away. Drury with a great chance. Drury has had 2 goals, 3 assists in the last 3 games, and he almost kept that streak alive right there.
Gary, what we've seen the last couple of minutes are such an indication of a team that is really hurting. That's the Washington Caps. They don't think they can win yet because they haven't. And the Colorado Avs, who have not lost this season in their first 5, who've got this killer instinct thing ratcheted up. I mean, they're trying to blow this thing open right now.
Yeah, put a team away when they can. That's what they'd like to do. Elf Dahlin sent it in. Back to get it, Patrick Waugh dumped it around the fire side. The shots are even at 2-2, but it's the Colorado Avalanche who have the lead. Caps haven't had a shot in the last 5 minutes. They've been dominated territorially as well by Colorado, and a penalty coming up. First call, and Washington will get a power play. Stephen Wacom and Dean Warren, are the officials for tonight's game, and the Caps will get a power play. Patrick Waugh, history-making chance tonight. Those 3 Stanley Cups he's won, now a chance to go to the top of the list for netminders. And a 1-0 lead. The first shot taken by the Avs. Tange got it, and it was a goal. And it has stood up here with 5:40 left to go in the first period. Nikolajan was tied up. Knocked back in by Klee. Miller back to get it double team. Shot it off the wall to get it out of trouble there and cleared it up into the middle.
What a smart play by Aaron Miller. That's one of those little things I was talking about before that some players don't get a lot of credit for. Aaron Miller never does anything flashy. Had nowhere to go. He banked it off the boards, took a hit, and went and got his own bank shot.
Kind of an unnoticed aspect of this Avs team, Bill, that they are deeper in D, I think, than most people realize because of people like Miller who don't get a lot of publicity.
Right.
And when you got this guy going for the record, you're not going to get a lot of publicity. He's chasing Terry Sawchuk, who died at the young age of 40 in 1970. And Patrick has said all along that he wishes Terry Sawchuk were still alive, that he might be here to be seeing this so he could talk with him.
And such, it's amazing, isn't it? Such different personalities and such different types of people. Terry Sawchuk, to me, was a gladiator that never wanted an audience, did not like people, did not mix, almost was an angry person. Patrick Waugh is one of the most jovial, fun people you'll ever meet. He thrives on audiences. He almost craves an audience.
Sawchuk last played 30 years ago. He was with Detroit for 14 years, Boston for two, Toronto, Los Angeles, and the New York Rangers for Sawchuk in his career. Banged up on the far side, Sylvain Cote put the hit on. Puck came to Clem, though. Clem, he'll feather that one off the far side boards. 8-5 the shots. Still in favor of the Caps. The lead still in favor of the Avs. 2-on-1 centered bullet. Side-made block. Rebound off the back of him, and he covers it up. Yan Bolas, the 22-year-old, almost.
Patrick Waugh had to be sensational. By far his best save of the game. And he had to be because a guy that never makes a mistake with the puck, Chris Drury, turned one over in the neutral zone. Here's Drury here. He fumbled with it in his skates. He came back with it. And then just like that, jumped up on the play. And Yan Bolas had a super scoring chance. Patrick Waugh had to come over really quickly to get on top of this one. He read it, though, all the way. And was actually over and waiting for Yan Bolas when he took the shot. So Patrick Waugh's best save of the game because of a turnover by a sure thing, Chris Drury.
Nine saves so far. Bolas, a nine-goal scorer last year out of the Czech Republic, played 56 games with the Caps. And behind the net, Alf Dahlin, the veteran, with it. Dahlin looking for his first goal as well. Left it. Zednik wants to go back to the point. Couldn't get there. Dahlin's got it. Dahlin, Bolas, and Richard Zednik on this line. Zednik leads the Caps in shots coming into the game with 13 on the year. And he's out there on the line, and oh, what a hit.
That's how you take the body, right there. Adam Foote with no concern at all about the puck, only with bumping Ulf Dahlin to the ice.
And almost picked up a penalty on that. Dahlin got pinned up against the wall. Foote stayed to make sure Dahlin was all right.
Dahlin, fortunately, was far enough away from the boards that he didn't hit the boards, I don't think. And I think that's why this wasn't a penalty. The other thing is Adam Foote took a hand off his stick. You see, Dahlin actually came down, helped himself by putting his left arm out. But Adam Foote smartly did not cross-check him. He just pushed him from behind with one arm. You see at real speed here.
And Ulf Dahlin is all right. And there's Adam Foote, who can hit. Only one shot in the last 6 minutes now for the Colorado Avalanche, being outshot 9-5 with four to go in the period. Deadmarsh heading to the middle, sidekick with a puck to Deadmarsh. Shot saved, rebound is loose, and Kolzig finds it. Sakic looking for the rebound as Ken Klee came by and pushed the puck back for his netminder.
You know, I think that trade, obviously it put the Colorado Avs, when Patrick Waugh left Montreal and went to Colorado, it put Colorado in a position to make a run for the Cup. They also got Mike Keane in the deal. To me, that marked the beginning of the downfall of the dynasty in Montreal that we will never see again. That was, they hurried the deal, they wanted to sweep it under the carpet. Patrick Waugh was the surest bet in a trade that you could get in the NHL. If you couldn't get blockbuster players back for Patrick Waugh, you couldn't get anybody, and they didn't.
That one chipped up in the air over the net. Look at Forsberg's work. Forsberg once, twice, and now it's poked away to the corner. Peter Forsberg has got two goals on the year, fighting for another. Forsberg shot, holding, another save, rebound, score! Milan Hajduk, a backhand rebound, and a 2-0 Avs lead.
What a series of plays by this line. See, that's why Colorado is so frustrating for a team like Washington to play against. Washington has been in Colorado's end for 10 solid minutes. The Forsberg line comes out, and they just start to weave their magic. And was it magical? Peter Forsberg, Gary, you called it on the one to start the play. He actually tapped it from behind the net to the front. They got it again, and Forsberg just bowled his way to the front, and Kolzig had no choice but to just fall down and try to protect as much of the net as possible. But there's such a killer instinct and an offensive excellence throughout that Colorado lineup that you think you got them on the ropes, and then bang, they nail you.
A 2-0 lead. Adam Deadmarsh holds it in. Deadmarsh, sidekick in front, taking the traffic. Tried to center, came back to him, shot, sidekick save, and deflected away. Wow. Hayduke gets the goal, 16-32. Forsberg picks up the assist on it. Hayduke's got three in the year. They're going after another. Deadmeyer just chipped it wide. Rebound to the near side. Shot by Miller. That one goes off a skate. Deadmeyer, 2:53 to go in the period. Left it for Sakic. Bondra's got it. Bondra brings it out. Nikolajan. Scoring line here. Wow, will hang on and get a whistle.
Here's one more look at the goal scored by Milan Hayduke. Once Kolzig ended up down and out, what'd Patrick think?
Big reaction there, Bill.
Gosh, you know, he's so prone to overreaction, isn't he? And listen, you know what you saw in his face? Continued concentration.
Still got a play, and that's why. Puck loose, side of the net. Yell, penalty coming. And there's the whistle. Good work, Bolas again. Jan Bolas has had two of the best chances in this game to get one by Patrick Roy. He had that one at the side of the net. Stefan Yell, though, is all over him. And Yell's going to go. Another power play for the Caps. It'll be their second of the game.
Washington has really had the territorial advantage in this period. Yes. Had a clock working, you would find more white jerseys in Patrick Roy's end than the other way around. There was the Yell takedown just to the side of the net, trying to help out Patrick Roy. Therein lies the difference in these two teams. Washington can dominate territorially and still lose a hockey game against a team like Colorado because the difference in their firepower.
Much more firepower with the Avs. Raymond Bourque couldn't clear the zone. Sakic came over to help, held in on the power play. 17:30, Yell for interference. Second power play of the game for the Caps. They've got plenty of time here. 2:15 left to go in the period. Centering pass block. Gonchar tried to run it through the middle. Zednik was there, and he never got it on the stick.
Boy, it's so hard to get a clear chop at the puck when you're an offensive player in front. If it doesn't happen, bang, bang, it's almost never going to happen. The defensive guys will get you.
Halpern brought that one up, dumped it deep. Patrick Wild loves to play the puck, came back to get it, hit Murphy's stick, and it'll be cleared out.
But true to his commitment, Gary, Patrick Roy is playing the puck less this season. He said he wanted to be more conservative, thought he took too many chances last season. So far this season, when we've seen him, he's true to his word.
Very conservative for him. Cleared around and not out of the zone. So they'll get to hold it in and continue this power play. Looking to set up in front. Otsu is a great passer. Connor Walchuk along the wall. Connor Walchuk turned it to the dot. Foot poked it away. Over to get it, Oates. Those of you watching St. Louis, Detroit, it's a 2-0 game here now. Shot on Wash, save made. Wash shutting out Washington. And he'll hang on. Little tangle behind the net here in Washington. Gary Thornbill, Clement, those of you have been watching that St. Louis-Detroit game. It's 2-0 here now as the Avs on goals by Tanguay at 1:11 and Hayduke at 16:32 have staked Patrick Roy to a 2-0 lead in that effort to pick up that win to make him the all-time winningest goaltender. And we've got 1:08 left to go here in this first period. Talked about the time he spent with the Canadiens. Well, that, of course, came to an end. December 2nd, 95, his worst game in a Montreal uniform, gave up 9 goals, cheered by the fans of the Forum. Before he finally got pulled, he was embarrassed. It would be his last game as a half. They got a trade to Colorado. It was an 11-1 loss. He walked behind his coach twice, went over to the owner of Montreal and apparently said, "I will never play again as a Canadien."
And I will say, we would not be sitting here tonight doing this game if Patrick Roy was still in Montreal, because he would not have the wins. That franchise has just tailed off, and he would not have nearly the wins that he has now.
Irony being on a centering pass back to the point. Shot, Kelly Hawks, and it's the outside of the net. Power play continuing with a minute to go in the period and 20 seconds to go in the advantage. That'll be cleared up and out. Patrick Roy, of course, grew up in Quebec. And the Quebec Nordiques are now the Colorado Avalanche. And where's Patrick Roy? Well, didn't make it exactly back to his home province, but he certainly made it to the home franchise.
I think that's what made it hardest for Montreal fans to swallow, that was that Patrick was not only leaving Montreal, but he was going to the enemy, the arch rival.
Down to 19 seconds to go in the period. Power play is over. Remains a 2-0 lead for the Colorado Avalanche. One period closer for Patrick Watt of the record. Into the middle. Zednik dropped it. Cutting. Just went wide off Dahlin. Dahlin, Bulas. Bulas poked it away. Kalle Johansson stepped up, but that will do it. Shots end up at 10-10, but after one. Our score here is 2-0. There's Patrick's wife. She's hoping there will indeed be a celebration in this game. Avalanche leaded by a score of 2-0 for Patrick Roy. The wife celebrates the saves. It's the way she likes it, gentlemen.
Once upon a time, this was extreme, but not anymore. Whether you're into boards, bikes, snow or surf, we've got them all. We bring you classic high-flying action from the innovators who revolutionized Xtreme. ESPN Classic Sport, greatness guaranteed.
Here we go to the second period. Peter Forsberg off the faceoff. It'll be won back by the Caps. Washington continues to struggle in scoring, being outscored now in the season 10-1 in the first period. DeVries came over to get it. Adam Footray, Bork both had a +2 in that period on the goals that were picked up by Tanguay and Hajduk. Foot and Bork an assist on the first one. Forsberg and Drury picking up assists on the second. Gonchar jammed up in the corner. Shots 10-10 through the first. And the Capitals turn it back up ice. Sent in, they'll change it up right here. Greg Berube dumped it back in. Roy came to play it in a collision on the intercept. Puck roll right in front. Shot score! Oh, Dahlin! And it's a 2-1 game.
Exactly the way the Washington Capitals wanted to and needed to come out and start the second period. Patrick Roy chopped down on the crossbar after this one went in because he ended up with a monster in front of him. Alf Dahlin picked up a loose puck that bounced between the skates of Aaron Miller and swung around in one sweeping motion. The hardest kind of shot to get a read on. And bang, found the corner. Patrick Roy had gone out to play the puck in areas. I think he might be angry at himself, not so much at Aaron Miller on the play, but the Caps nevertheless have done what they had to do, and that is come out and jump back into this tilt.
Alf Dahlin, the veteran, gets his 247th career goal in his 762nd game to make it 2-1, and Roy's watching it.
See the play at the blue line that was picked up after Patrick Roy cleared the puck, and that is why I think he was most upset. Gosh, even a great effort by Alex Tanguay was fought off by Alf Dahlin. This is a great play by Dahlin. But when he swung around and just flicked it with the toe of his stick, there was not much room between the skate and the post for Alf Dahlin to hit. But he found daylight and he found twine and made it a 2-1 game.
43 seconds into the period, Dahlin gets his first goal of this campaign. Nikolajan pick up the assists on it. 2-1. DeVries lost it. Another chance. Zednik shot. Save. Roy. Penalty coming. Delayed call. Zednik on the near side. Kolzig to the bench. Here's the whistle. So the Capitals have come out storming in the first minute and a half of the second period.
And they've really been helped by Colorado coming out and making mistakes. I mean, it doesn't matter how bad a team is struggling. If you give them opportunities and make mistakes, it's going to happen. There's another one. I mean, it was a bounce that Greg DeVries tried to short hop with the glove, and it went under him. And he had to really try to come back and try to throw Zednik off somehow, and he did. He hooked him. He's going to pay. So a couple of bounces, a couple of miscues by the Colorado Avs, and the Washington Capitals all of a sudden look like a team that has had life just injected into their veins.
Be the third power play of the game coming up. DeVries at 118 on that hooking call. So Waz got to face the power play again with the 0 for 2. The Caps are now 3 for 26 on the season. And they'll have to chase it to their own zone. Helfrin back to get it. He's picked up a goal on the year. Working on the power play. Helfrin's pass came loose. Yell didn't get all of that one. Knocked away by Olaf Kolzig. Capitals will try it again. Gonchar. Goal and an assist for him on the year so far. Cutting near side, deflected shot. Wild with a big save. What a play of Joe Murphy. Murphy again. Murphy centered shot, deflected to the short side. Not quite on net. Konowalczuk. Great play here in this power play. Gonchar threw a screen too high. Banged away by Jeff Helfrin. He couldn't get it on net. The Capitals do not look like the team that played the first period of this game.
No, they look confident. Colorado was running around on their penalty kill. And when Adam Oates is out there and you can plug him into the middle of a play, he is always going to make something good happen.
Joe Murphy to Kalle Johansson. Fireside Gonchar shot save made. Patrick Roy will hold it in the glove.
Not even a thought of putting this puck back into play. Patrick Roy understands his guys are under the gun. They're running around. Slow it down. Settle it down.
Five scoring chances in this period, and we're only 2.5 minutes into it for the Caps.
Still, this is exactly where Ronnie Wilson wishes he had big Chris Simon sitting on his bench. Chris Simon is not here. Contract, no contract, and they're really not that close on a deal just yet, the Washington Caps and Chris Simon. Simon was their top goal scorer last season with 29, but he's a hulk of a man. And when you put a hulk of a man in front of even Patrick Roy, you've got a way more threatening and more valuable and more dangerous.
Big physical presence, Simon. And as Bill said, not close to getting it done. Great passing here. Centered block and deflected away. Zednik was charging the net. The puck went over his stick. 42 seconds remaining on the power play. Caps with a chance to get this game tied up. Sent into the middle. Bork had it. Lost it. Centered to Bulis. Bulis got tagged. Shot deflected off the side of the net. Zednik again. Bulis had gotten leveled. Zednik tried to feed it back to him. It ended up on Waugh. Kalle Johansson. Johansson leaves it. Fireside Gonchar. Johansson saved by Waugh with a left pad.
Man, what a save.
Those watching St. Louis, Detroit, welcome back to Washington. 9 seconds left on a Capitals power play. They scored an early goal here in the second period to make this a one-goal game, 2-1, with the Avs on top. The goal picked up by Dahlin at 43 seconds into the game. Then a Colorado penalty into this period, rather. Power play, though, is over. They do not convert their 0-for-3 in the power play.
Boy, did they come close. And it is looking now, as bad as the power play looked for Washington in the first period, it is looking like a finely oiled, finely tuned machine.
Touched up by Miller. Shots now 17-11 on the game in favor of the Caps, but they've come out storming here in the first 3.5 minutes of period two. 30-year-old netminder 0-2 in the year so far. Craig Billington, the backup, played the first 3 games until Kolzig could get back from the injury operation. Forsberg had it knocked away. Bondra sends it in. DeVries back to get it. Greg DeVries off the near side. Peter Forsberg. Forsberg in. Forsberg the move. Down the middle. Forsberg. And a big-time save by Olaf Kolzig. Forsberg, who can dangle with the best of them, carried that one right through the middle. When he clears it out to center.
What a smart play Forsberg made. He knew that Kolzig was coming across. He just took a nice little gentle shot that was going to take time to get to the goal, hoping that Kolzig would clear. Ole's got long enough legs that he dragged one behind.
Icing call coming up here as Kalle Johansson will chase it down and gets the whistle.
Bob Hartley rode this Forsberg line a lot in the first period, and he's going to do it here again in the second period. Flanked by Milan Hajduk and Chris Drury. It's a scary line to have to play against. Drury and Forsberg bring a physical presence. They'll rattle your jaw if you're not looking. They can also light it up. Watch Forsberg cut to the middle here as soon as he saw a chance to. But watch his shot. Just a nice little gentle shot back to the net, hoping that Kolzig would have slid out of the way, but Kolzig with his long legs was able to get it. There's the line sitting and regrouping, waiting for another shift, and I bet you Hartley has him out there in no time.
One of the best lines in the National Hockey League right there. Washington won 68% of the faceoffs in the first period, and they're doing it again here. Centering pass did not go through. That bounced off bodies to Sackett. Sakic will move this one up. Tanguay has got a goals on the left. Ed Marsh on the right. Sakic in the middle. Kolzig misplayed. Rolled in front. Sakic. Kolzig down. Rebound off the side of the net. Kolzig had not gotten position back that time as the puck hit the side of the net. Deadmarsh, two good chances so far in this game. Sakic takes it away from Connor Walchuk, but the Caps will regroup behind the net.
Alex Tanguay never let up on the forecheck, and his pursuit had to surprise Olaf Kolzig. He came at him from behind and forced the turnover.
Aaron Miller able to block that one. Shot right into him. Caps got to get back on side. They do not before Black. James Black brings that one back into the zone.
You got to know what's behind you when you go behind the net as a goalie to get the puck, and that's what Kolzig did on the play that ended up being a turnover. Well, he had somebody in front of him, but here's what happened behind him. Tanguay just never let up on the throttle. Full speed, he went in on the forecheck, and this is what happened. Joe Sakic just about had one. Couple of chances in front. And you can see Kolzig got back, but he wasn't in any shape to be square to the shot, to have his pads in the right position. And there's the man that caused the turnover with his speed, Alex Tanguay.
Big star last year, young player, and they brought along some good ones here. Tanguay is another, joins Chris Drury, played so well. Skoulos playing so well on defense. Milan Hajduk, that's part of the depth of this Colorado team, looking for the touch up in the icing. Ken Klee went back to get it and did. Icing call.
Well, it's time to check the Avalanche depth chart in the children department. We know they got a lot of scoring depth. Maybe there'll be more scoring depth in the Sakic family, because Joe's wife Debbie on Saturday gave birth to twins. Little girl they named Cameron, little boy they named Chase. Three kids total now in the Sakic family. So congratulations to Debbie and Joe Sakic.
Making that new contract for Sakic even more important. Many feel he is not going to be back in Colorado next year.
It'll be interesting to see what kind of season he had, because I talked to Pierre Lacroix, the GM, today, and he said, you know, our goal is always going to be the same. It is to keep our core players here in Colorado. And I asked him about Patrick Laine. He said, yeah, we're going to try and sign him. And they'll try to sign Sakic, but can they get it done?
Can't sign everybody. That's what happens in all sports in this day and age. You group these great stars. Ask the Montreal Expos how tough that is to do. They've supplied players to an entire league. Raymond Bourque comes back to get it. It is a 2-1 Avalanche lead. The faceoffs now 20-9 in favor of Washington. Avs have got to pick that pace up. Those draws have given some chances. Also, the Avs don't need any more penalties, as the Caps have picked up 11 of their shots, 11 of the 17 off the three power play chances that they've had. In behind the net, Tanguay's got it again. Tanguay looking back up on top for Clem Stolen. Gonchar had it, deflected away to Klee. Klee got it out. Murphy tried to reach back, could not get it. And the centering pass bumped away by Klee again to center. Caps trying to find some scoring strength. Bonder's the man they look to most. They need others to help out. There's Connor Walchuk, one who can do it. His pass intercepted. Sakic's got it. Sakic turning back in. Messier heading to the net. Messier tried to tip. Went straight through instead. Kolzig knocked it away. Colorado trying to complete their line change here. Sakic got out there with the end of another line. DeVries back to get it. Dumps it in. Wide side. Deadmarsh is just heading off the ice. Didn't touch it, though. Fireside Gonchar. Gonchar. Changes made. Kolzig a save. Rebound. Parker save made. Kolzig again. Scott Parker looking for his first point of the year. A dead-on shot. Picked back up by Dave Reed. Checking lines out there again with Parker, Miller, and Reed. That goes into the seats. Delighted to have you with us. History-making night. We're going to find out.
Now, just like anything else in life, if it's in...
Oh, no! What a shot! Peter Bondra! 2-2!
Well, to finish that thought... If it's any good, it's never that easy. The Avs had a 2-0 lead. Washington stormed out here in the second period, have taken the play away from Colorado, and now, because of a turnover in the zone by Joe Sakic, have made this a 2-2 game. Peter Bondra had been looking for a tally this season to get his game underway. He's had a couple already. This is goal number 3. He is the last guy you want to give one of those quick turnovers to, because he's going to bury most of them no matter what your name is in goal.
You saw the great shooter shot right there as he put that one upstairs. Peter Bondra, three goals on the season, has tied this game up at 2-2. The goal coming at 16:08. Two goals in the second for the Caps.
And it's mistakes now that are costing Colorado. That and bouncing pucks. The puck is alive out there. I'm sure the Colorado guys are going back to the bench saying, be careful with it because it is bouncing like crazy. Joe Sakic tried a backhand pass. Not sure who he was trying to get it to, but it was a low percentage play, and Peter Bonder made him pay. Patrick Waugh hardly had a chance to react because the play happened so close to him. Joe Sakic turned the puck over about 6 feet outside the hash marks, and bang, was behind him.
And another chance. Waugh trying to cover. Puck is loose. And he gets a whistle. That puck was still loose. Patrick Waugh facing heat in this game. Peter Bondra at 16:08 has tied it up. Connor Walchuk got the assist on the tying goal. Dahlin had one at 43 seconds. Colorado had a 2-0 lead in the first. Now it's 2-2. And the Caps continue to keep the heat on here. Their chances have been outstanding. There's Bondra. Wilson getting him right back out on the ice against the Sakic line. Bondra is one of those people under attack here, saying he wanted to be traded, doesn't want to stay. There were many who were saying he was not playing with any pizzazz. Well, he did on that one. Blocked by Kolzig, who himself has made some outstanding saves in this game. Foot held it in. Connor Walchuk got it out of there. Cleared back into the middle. Raymond Bourque on a backhand to take it away from Bondra. Out the center, Hajduk, two on two. Hajduk whistled. Behind the play, a two-line pass.
The Caps are coming now. This team looked like a team that had not won a game in the season in the first period, and the Avs looked like a team that was undefeated on the season. But it is a marathon. It is not a sprint. Slowly but surely, at some point in the season, the fortunes turn. Maybe this is the fortunes turning for the Washington Caps. Ulf Dahlin has had a strong second period. He scored the first Capitals goal, and now Peter Bondra has tied it. The Capitals didn't really have much to rally around. They've had trouble scoring. They still never led at any point in this hockey season, and this is game number six.
They're out shooting the Avalanche 25-23. Their scoring chances, though, are piling up. 14 scoring chances in this game. A number of them coming on their power play, of which they have had four but haven't converted. The check put on Ulf Dahlin. Miller. They bang it up against the wall. Colorado with a puck. Forsberg lost it again. Shot save. Rebound. Shot wide. Two chances. Zednik. That's what Bill was talking about. Another turnover. And of all people, Peter Forsberg gave it up right in front of Waugh.
If you don't have speed and you end up with the puck in your end and you stand there or even are moving slowly, somebody that really wants it is going to get you from behind. And that's what Zednik did to Forsberg.
Forsberg tied up far side. Kicked around and down behind the net. Good play made by Drury. Centering pass knocked away by Kolzig. And the Caps come. Almost caught a D back. Jan Bulas. His pass going to create an offside. 2:03 to go. Second period. 2-2.
Well, fair is fair. What happened on the play on this last one is Peter Forsberg went in to get the puck from Ulf Dahlin. Dahlin was doing a good job fighting Miller. But watch Forsberg come in and say, I'll take this. And he made one move. Well, I'll give Peter Forsberg the benefit of the doubt. He came back and tried to make it happen. Lost his glove on the play and everything. Zednik just hustled him on that play. Just hustled him. Peter Forsberg wasn't dallying, looking for somebody to pass. He had to beat one guy, and then Zednik just tracked him down from behind. So that was more a good Zednik play than a bad Forsberg play.
Whatever Ron Wilson said to these troops, or maybe said nothing between the first and second, whatever it was or wasn't, it worked. They have come out here an entirely different team in this period after trailing 2-0 at the end of one.
I don't think he could use the tirade move again. He used that in practice yesterday, so I don't
May
think
just
he
just stayed away.
Yep.
In behind the net, blocked. Joe Sakic came on, went right by the puck as Jeff Halpern trying to freeze it up. Sakic came back again to get it. Sakic turns it back in behind the net. Halpern doing battle with Klemm. Klemm, penalty coming, delayed call. It'll be against Colorado. Black the chance. Blocked, and there's the whistle. And another power play coming.
It'll be interesting to see how the Caps react if they can get the lead. because they have had to play with adversity in all of their games so far this season. Now they've got a chance in the power play to go up by a goal. All Ronnie Wilson wanted his guys to do, and we talked about the tirade that he unleashed on his players yesterday in practice. He wanted them to practice hard, and he wouldn't name names, but he said there were a handful of guys that did not come prepared to practice. And he is a believer, as I am, that if you can't prepare to practice hard, you're not going to come prepared to play hard. There was the hold, and that was a pretty legitimate call. So John Klemm is going to sit for holding.
This will be power play number 5. Power play numbers have been up, as was expected, with the calls that are being called closely here at the start of the year. And the Capitals have not converted on a power play yet, but they've had chances 0 for 4, but 13 shots off the power play. Sean Podine.
Gosh, the puck is bouncing, Gary. I mean, I'll tell you what. I mean, that could favor Colorado in a shorthanded sense, and it might work against Washington, but the puck is absolutely alive out there.
Not sitting flat on the ice, all over the place. Wah played it around Bondra, and it'll be cleared out of the zone. No short-ended goals have been scored by the Capitals this season. Colorado Avalanche have scored 1. Power play here for the Caps. Deflected away by Adam Foote. Chased down by Jeff Halpern. 33 to go in the period. Time running out, more than that on the power play. That'll be whistled, and the faceoff will come at center. Caps could have a lead in this game, Bill.
Well, they could. Patrick Waugh has gotten the benefit of the doubt on a couple of whistles, a couple of quick whistles. On this play by Joe Murphy, he came in and crashed. And then Joe Sakic turned one over. Peter Bondra made the Avs pay.
Face off at center with 29 to go in the period and a minute 10 on the power play for the Caps. Kelly Johansson sends it in. Wah again coming out. Wah going a little further out of the net here in this power play than he had earlier in the game. Messier's got it. Messier is able to clear that one out. Kolzig at the other end holds it up. Kelly Johansson back to get it. Down to 10 to go in the period. 50 to go on the power play. Caps, they'll just gun it in on Wah. He wants to keep that clock going here, so he plays it off the boards to Dave Reed. Kelly Johansson knocked it away from him, and that's the end of the second period. Washington has come back to make it interesting. Has over 100,000 hockey trading cards in his collection. A couple dozen of those are of Terry Sawchuk. He's long been a fan and student of the game. He's got a great memorabilia collection. One of the things they've wondered about, if Wild wins tonight, the Hockey Hall of Fame wants to get as many items as they can, but they know how much Patrick likes to collect them, so how much is he going to give? How much is he going
to
give?
Might have to buy part of his collection. And there is Michelle with an E, Patrick's wife. Doesn't get a chance to see that many games on the road, but she is here tonight hoping that her husband can get this thing done and move into the number one spot for all-time wins in the NHL. Also, the commissioner of the National Hockey League, Gary Bettman, is on hand. And if Patrick Waugh is able to win this game and his team, there will be a ceremony following the tilt honoring Patrick.
And we will have that for you. Faceoffs have mattered in this game. They've been the Washington Capitals plus 58% faceoffs won with the Caps. Power play, 34 seconds left on it for Washington. Is their fifth power play of the game. They've not converted on the previous 4. Game tied at 2, and we are in the third period. Wondering if it will be a record-breaking night. Adam Foote had it. Held in the zone? No. Came outside, offside, and the faceoff will be at center.
Gosh, Patrick got the benefit of the doubt on a couple of whistles, but now the lights are even going off behind him. Maybe his luck is turning for the worse. That's signifying a goal, or either that or the goal judge. Yeah, and he's on the phone too. He wants to talk to somebody. The goal judge that is sitting back there has a question for Steve Walkham or somebody else.
Apparently can't get the light shut off.
Let's hear what Steve Walkham saying. Raise your hand. If the light is stuck on, Steve Walkham is telling the goal judge to do it the way they did it years ago. Just raise your hand when a goal is scored.
Unscrew the ball.
No. Maybe that's what you're saying. Raise your hand and unscrew the darn thing.
Could be a bit disconcerting to be playing at that end for the Capitals even to be looking at the goal they're shooting at, seeing the red light on all the time. It's not they don't want that, but it would help if the puck had crossed the line when it happened. And we're going to wait a minute here to see, I guess, see whether or not they can get this taken care of. No, we're not going to wait.
There are a couple of old-fashioned remedies. Oh, look
here's Bondra making lift. Yes! Keep that light on! Peter Bondra, for the first time this year, the Capitals have a lead in the game. It's 3-2.
Mistake after mistake are starting to pile up. And the Washington Capitals now look more like Colorado than they do Washington. They're taking advantage of mistakes and making Colorado pay. Right off the faceoff, Sean Podine was lined up over in the top right. That's Podine, 25 for Colorado, and Peter Bondra just wasted him. Blew by him. Had to be a set play on the faceoff with Adam Motes pushing the puck ahead to Peter Bondra. He gave him backhand, forehand, and bang. And now the red light has gone off.
Wow, how's that for an omen? Wow.
There's a towel being thrown to the goal judge, but he might not need it any longer because the light is off. Who knows whether it's fixed or not? Who cares? Peter Bondra, his second goal of the game, his fourth goal on the season off another... That was a set play by Washington that Colorado wasn't able to handle. Sean Podine lost Bondra.
Those watching the St. Louis-Detroit game, history's going to get a little tougher to be made here. Peter Bondra has scored a power play goal. Starting the third period at 25 seconds in, Bondra's second goal of the night to give the Capitals their first lead of the year in six games. 3-2.
Boy, what a great play by Bondra here. Now look at the top of the screen. Sean Podine lost Bondra. Oates pushed it ahead to Connor Walchuk, and Connor Walchuk just dished off to Bondra. Now the defensemen on the play are not worried about Bondra because it's the winger's responsibility to hold him up at the blue line.
First time this year that Patrick Waugh has given up more than two goals in a game. A 1.36 goals against coming into this, 9.35 save percentage. Shot wide off the faceoff. The Washington Capitals, keep in mind, are trying to win their first game of the year. They are 0-3-2, while Colorado's not lost a game. They are 3-0-2. And the Caps, after a very bad, poorly played first period, put a very tough second period up and have come right back, started that way here in the third. Chris Drury got it up ahead, Forsberg, Hejduk. Hejduk looking into the middle, taken off the play on the near side by Klee. Still loose in the corner. Dug out, Helprin in there doing battle. Hejduk a little pick, Forsberg centered shot. Colson came across. Hejduk may have been the one to block the on Drury's shot. The shot just deflected off skates.
Ken Klee might have been the guy that saved the day, too. He got around so quickly. It looked like Chris Drury had a wide-open cage, and as he was making sure, Ken Klee might have just come down and chopped him.
Good play by Klee, who got back, and now a stick. Deadmarsh is down, a stick to the face. Adam Deadmarsh seems to be one of those players who can pick up more cuts around the facial area in the course of a season than anyone in the league, and he's got another one.
Well, he'll take this one as long as it was seen, and there's going to be a major penalty called as a result of it.
I didn't see any arm go up.
I didn't either.
But they can discuss that and call it.
Maybe it was the puck. Might not have been a stick. No wonder an arm didn't come up. It happened right down on the near boards to us. Boy, he's got some blood flowing now. Scar tissue on top of scar tissue. The way of life for a hockey player.
So Deadmarsh, their leading goal scorer, along with Milan Hejduk, they each have three. He's got to go get that taken care of before he can come back into the game. Let's see what happened.
Of course, there are all kinds of objects that you get cut with, including the boards, the ice, the glass. This happens over on the right. Yeah, the puck came up. I think see the puck falling down. I think the puck hit him in the face.
He blocked the puck, side of his head. Dumped back in by Zednik. Zednik left it behind the net. Dahlin. Alf Dahlin looking out in front, trying to find Zednik, who's moving around. Off the Zednik, shot blocked. DeVries stood in front of him on that one. Alf Dahlin. Again, Zednik had it, lost it. And Zednik reached in and is going to get a penalty. Delay call coming up. That'll be dumped in on goal. Covered up. Kolzig power play for the Avs. But the Capitals have a 3-2 lead. The Avs will get a chance here, trailing by a goal on the power play to get this game tied up again. Patrick Waugh looking for victory, 4:48, but the Caps have had the last three goals. Zednik goes, hooking at 2:24.
And that was an offensive zone penalty. Coaches don't like to see those. Players got to go an awful long way to generate a scoring chance when they're in their defensive zone. Washington was in their offensive zone. That's where Zednik took Forsberg down.
Sakic won the draw. The Avs can't hold it in. Rieke cleared it out. Wah behind the net. Patrick Bort. That was Freudian slip right there. Raymond Bort brings it up, working the point with Adam Foote. Near side held in by Drury. Forsberg into the corner. Forsberg helping along the wall. Foote trying to get it back to Forsberg. Can't. Cleared out Adam Oates.
Great work by Adam Oates. I mean, Adam Oates' anticipation is second to none as well. Great passer, one of the 10 greatest in the game in my mind. But his anticipation defensively is right up there as well.
Sent in around the near side dasher. Nikolajan got it. Foote holds it in. Colorado trying to get the power play set up here. They've not converted on their first two chances of the game. Forsberg on the far side. Forsberg all the way up to the blue line. Raymond Bork back to him. Forsberg back. Bork one-timer deflected. Foote center shot. Score! What a play by Adam Foote! Adam Foote made a magnificent pass. And this game is tied at 3.
The one thing that hasn't changed in this hockey game is Patrick Waugh's expression. Adam Foote had to know exactly what he wanted to do with the puck as soon as it came to him. Broken play. Ray Bork came up with a big one-timer and it bounced to Adam Foote. Trying to figure out. I honestly do not know why Adam Foote picked up the puck on that play. It's his first goal of the season. I'm not sure whether it's a milestone of his. I should know, but I don't.
Just like the goal, just like that puck, that's all. He had a
unique look to it. Of the 9 million he's seen in his lifetime.
He'd never seen one quite like that one.
Never seen one quite like that. I don't think Foote got the goal. Foote should get an assist. Sakic, I think, picked up the goal.
Right.
On that.
Adam did not score. I mean, he made a beautiful. I don't know if it was a milestone for him or if it was a milestone for Joe Sakic.
Kelly Johansson cleared it around. Joe Sakic printed it with a goal. It'll be his first of the year. Adam Foote sent him up. And it came at 3:27. Ray Bork also gets an assist on it and ties this game. It is a power play goal, 1-for-3. On the power play for the Avs. So each team's got a power play goal. We've had 8 total power plays tonight. Dropped back by Hajduk, third period. So Patrick Waugh's chance with that record win. Still alive here. Bondra poke checked away. Kote and Rieke. Kote dropped it in the middle. Both teams changing. Rieke on the near side. Waugh at the end of the stick, up and over the glass. That deflected. No delay there. 4.5 into period number 3. Sakic ties it.
Sometimes being in the right place at the right time is the most dangerous kind of player to have to defend against. Olaf Kolzig found that out the hard way because Adam Foote was stationed. See, to the left, you'll see Adam Foote. He didn't even try to shoot, although Kolzig was over there to face the Adam Foote shot. Michelle with an E loved it. But I'm not there yet. This is now a 3-3 hockey game.
And a good one. There's Sakic getting goal number 1 of the year to go with the 3 assists that he had coming into this game. Face off to the right side of Waugh. This time it'll be picked up on the win by Drury. And cleared out of the zone. Reed tied up. Sylvain Kote had him clear the puck. Cleave. Rubbed out along the near side boards. Good work by Messier. Drury got knocked down as he tried to play that. Bondra going for the hat trick in this game. Clears it up. Could be an icing call coming on the touch, and it is right there. Great to have all of you with us as the chase is on for hockey history tonight. Patrick Waugh looking for his 448th win, which would move him ahead of the all-time leader for 30 years, Terry Sawchuk. Those are the numbers of the two great players. Talking about the wins, Al was with Patrick's dad. He said the other day when he was asked about all the wins he has, he said, I've never won a hockey game. How can I win a hockey game if I don't score goals? I save, I do not win.
That's funny. Oh, what a shot. He says that at one point, but I remember talking to him last year when he said, hey, listen, some guys get paid to score, some guys get paid to check. I get paid to win.
The W's, as his father said, are the things he wants to put up on the board. Boy, he has done that. 14:35 to go, third period. Game tied, 3-3. Nicolision down low, centering pass blocked. And the Avs move it up to the blue, and out Dingman's got it. Dingman will send it in from the red line, and on that stick, caught a little piece of Murphy as he was following through on the dump in.
You know, over the years as well, besides watching Patrick Waugh stop countless number of shots, it'll be a good story when I get to it.
3-3 game. We're going to go back to John Saunders.
The thing about Patrick Waugh, watching him through all of his wins and all of the pucks that he has stopped and all of his great moments, I think Kevin Allen, who does such a great job of covering hockey for USA Today, said it best about Patrick Waugh. We've seen this as well. He lives for the games within the games. And that is why he has been such a colorful character in his career in the NHL.
You got to enjoy the sport if you're going to live it that way. And he does. I mean, he genuinely loves being out here. It's why he wants to continue his career for years, he hopes. He's 35 years old now. It's his 847th game played. Colorado trying to get a lead for him right here. Tange has got a goal. Miller got knocked down, picked back up, cleared up by Cote, held in. Tange in the corner. Miller dropped it to Sakic, and a whistle away from the puck as the net has come off the Marsh pegs. We'll be right back. Well, we were just saying, Bill, if you're going to get this career mark for Patrick Waugh, why not have a great game to do it in?
Yeah, you want to have a little bit of sizzle, and both of these teams have shown signs of really kind of being sloppy defensively in this game, but I'll tell you what, in the third period, it's really heated up. Patrick Waugh and Olaf Kolzig have had to be at their best, really trying to keep their teams at least in this tie.
Both goaltenders have had to make some very big saves in the course of this game. And we remain tied 3-3 with 4:20 left to go in period number three. Connor Walchuk's helmet taken off. Forsberg with the puck. Forsberg off the wall for Hejduk. Too far ahead of him. Rieke lost it. Drury had it. Hejduk got it. Back to Adam Foote. Foote trying to wrist it. Forsberg the turn. Forsberg takes Rieke behind the net. Forsberg backhand chance. Forehand shot. That deflected off skates. Oates had gotten in to help out. And that's cleared out. An icing call coming up on the touch at the other end by Adam Foote. 3:52 remaining to go in the third. What a finish. Washington Capitals wanting that first W to get this start of the season on. Something in that column on the left.
Well, if the Avs get it done, I mean, this is what I said in the first period. This has been by far their most threatening line offensively. Peter Forsberg with Hejduk and Drury. Peter Forsberg's had the puck on a string. Look at this. Joe Rieke has to lay off of him because Forsberg will just beat you. And Peter Forsberg knows that Joe Rieke doesn't have that much speed. He's not very fast. So what did Forsberg do? Took him wide around the net, found room, spun around, and generated another scoring chance.
Dead Marsh trying to run that one in. Klee got there to get a piece of it. That'll end up going up and over the glass. They'll get some more chances here. They won't be out for very long. This point of the game, you put your offensive lines out there and let them go.
And most teams, when they have a line like this, and Bob Hartley has this line of Forsberg, Hejduk, and Drury, one guy's kind of the checker on the line or doesn't contribute as much offensively. But any one of those three can take you down. I mean, they're all capable of scoring big goals, seeing the big play, making the big play. I mean, they can hurt you, every one of them.
Draw one back by Sakic. Greg DeVries shot. Save made by Kolzig into the corner. Dead Marsh came over to get a Tange. Sakic couldn't reach in and free that one up. Caps get it out to center. Moved up by Black. Black pinned up on the near side boards by Clem. Puck still free in the corner. Poked away to DeVries. Black got it back. Still loose against the wall. No whistle. Officials want to play in this thing. Back in behind the net. The battle's still going on down there. As Caps try to get somebody open in front. Black came in to help out. Sakic on his back. Puck's up against the wall. Here the officials hollering, move it, move it. Sakic does. Sakic took it away. Sakic, Deadmarsh ahead of him on the right. Sakic on the crisscross, sent it in. It rebounded out the center. Picked up by James Black, and that'll be whistled from behind. And the faceoff is going to come, I believe, just inside the Washington zone. Going for this record. Oh, my. The whole team involved now.
The fun part of it is when you start in the NHL, and especially for me, all I wanted was to survive. You know, I was hoping to make the Montreal Canadiens and hoping one day I'd be in the NHL. And now, when you start your first year, I said, hey, I just want to survive in that league as long as I can. And then here we are, I mean, today, I mean, in that position, and be able to pass the best goaltender who played the game.
Gary Sawchuk, the man, he's tied and now trying to move ahead of in this game tonight. Cleared back out into the middle. Caps, Dahlin. Wah back out to play it. Off the glass, Reed. Reed blocked by Cully Johansson. Dahlin over again. Reed ran it up. Gonchar held it in. In the corner, they look to the middle. Zednik. Zednik, fine offensive player. Taken out of the play. Dahlin out in front, side of the net on the pass. Dahlin tried to get that one back to himself, could not. Colorado will get it. Avs, Yell. Stefan Yell sends that in. We're down to 2:10 to go in the third period. 29-28, the shots in favor of the Avs. It remains a tie game here in this third period. Connor Walchuk is up ice. Bondra's got two goals. Tried to pass it into Connor Walchuk and lost it. Milan Hayduk. Hayduk shot blocked. Sent back up Bork. Bork can't hold it in. There's that bouncing puck Bill's talked about tonight. All over the place. Forsberg had cleared the zone, so they were onside on the send-in. Behind the net, Sylvain Côté dropped it, lost it. Looking Forsberg, trying to set it. Deflected. And out it comes again, Raymond Bork. Bork being chased by Bondra. Cleared it back out into the middle. Kelly Johansson. Washington clears and dumps. Minute 23 to go, third period. All the way to center. Sylvain Côté in trouble finding that. Forsberg couldn't control. Oates back out. Connor Walchuk. Connor Walchuk sends it in. Wide. Bondra chasing. Bondra taken out of the play. Skula cleared out. Messier back in. Deadmarsh has got it. Down to a minute four. 3-3 game. Deadmarsh dumped it in. Tanguay has got a goal. Tanguay center is lost. Tip to the point. 1 minute to go in the regulation. 3-3 game here. Patrick Waugh at the other end watching as they start up ice. Intercepted by Miller. Avs get onside. Dumped in by Martin Skula. Off the near side. Bork, what a crunching hit. Puck came back out the center. Oh, my.
Ken Klee just crushed Joe Sakic.
Sakic back up. Klee went to the bench. Sakic still out skating. Down to 28 seconds. That's Sakic, who the puck just went by. Jan Poulos got it in. Skula trying to drive it out. Deadmarsh couldn't get it out. Yell can't get it out. Still in the zone. Dahlin shot. Save made by Wah. Oh, Dahlin with 17 seconds left. Got a backhander off the interception. Messier in the corner. Shot wide. Gonchar. Cully Johansson held in. Dahlin. Dahlin to Poulos. Shot. Save. And it's set right in the crease. And we're going to go to OT. A 3-3 regulation finish. Well, if the Avs can get the overtime goal, maybe Patrick Waugh says I never win games. He might want to rethink that. After the saves he just made to send this into overtime like that, maybe indeed he does win games. OT coming up. So if Patrick Waugh is to be the winningest goaltender ever in National Hockey League history, tonight it will have to come in OT by one goal. 3-3. Patrick Waugh has won 137 games by one goal in his career.
This will be interesting, too, to see this 4-on-4. The Avs have a little more depth up front and guys that can really scoot and really score. But when the Capitals have either Kalle Johansson or Sergei Gonchar on the blue line, I think they've got the advantage. One way or the other, this should be pretty good.
Overtime, next goal wins. Kalle Johansson, 5 minutes to play. Bondra's in front, deflected to the near side. Caps putting the heat on early. Sylvain Cote, shot, rolled into the corner. Bondra came after, got it to Oates. Oates, he can set you up, not that time. 2-on-1 the other way. Can they get it right here? Forsberg up, Drury with him. Forsberg dropped it. What a save!
Well, I will not take anything away from Olaf Kolzig on this save because it was a great one. But the whole world knows that Peter Forsberg is going to pass here. So Olaf Kolzig is standing with the weight on the left foot so that he's got a good edge to shove off and make a big save. Peter Forsberg is one of the most predictable players in the NHL on a 2-on-1 because 99 times out of 100, he will shoot. Ray Bourque is the guy that almost ended it with a little chip shot, but the puck was lined too close to Olaf Kolzig.
This is sports wonderful. Raymond Bourque has scored more points against Patrick Waugh than any player in NHL history. Almost won the game to give Waugh the win to move him into that number one spot in wins. We continue. 4:20 to go in the OT. Miller back to get it. Tied up far side by Halperin. Puck loose along the wall. Gonchar. Gonchar's played a heck of a game. Gunned that one in wide. Still Halperin holding it against the boards. Lost it. Hayduk out. Hayduk's got psychic on the right. 4-on-4, of course, an OT offside.
What Bob Hartley has done here is taken Milan Hayduk away from Peter Forsberg. And naturally, with the 4-on-4, you got two forwards out there. Took Hayduk away from Forsberg and Drury and has him out here on this shift with Joe Sakic. So that was the depth I was talking about that the Hartley bench has that is very difficult for Washington to match. But, Gary, you've already mentioned Sylvain Cote's name, Kalle Johansson's name, and Sergei Gonchar's name. They've been threatening guys in the OT, so that's the way this kind of shapes up.
Face off at center. Forsberg still thinking about the goal that wasn't scored on that 2-on-1 breakaway. And no one would have wanted that goal more than Raymond Bourque on that follow-up chance. Bourque's back out on the ice here. Tanguay on the near side had to come back to get it. Foot and Bourque, Tanguay and Deadmarsh. Cote on D with Kalle Johansson. Jan Boulos out there as well for the Caps. Shot, foot wide. Rebound. You got Tanguay in front. Centering pass came to Boulos. Boulos got a chance for 2-on-1 the other way now as well. Up ice they come. Zednik. Zednik. Kalle Johansson cutting shot. That just was wide. On the stick side, Johansson. He's loose in front again. Pass to him. Blocks it behind the net by Adam Foote.
Oh, man. There was a trip by Patrick Waugh. He got away with it.
Foote colliding over there with Zednik. Wow, is it getting tough. Penalty coming. Penalty coming.
Boy, it'll be interesting to see what this call is with 3:19 to go in overtime because it looked like Zednik came up and just cross-checked Adam Foote either in the throat or the mouth.
Very upset Sylvain Cote because the puck came to him in the middle and he was all alone, but the penalty had already been called.
Well, we'll see if these are coincidental. Or we'll see if Richard Zednik has dug himself a little bit of a hole. There it is, Adam Oates. It looked like he got cross-checked in the face, and he did. Adam Oates wants him to take a look at the blood because with 3:19 to go, this has a chance of being a four-minuter. After that, watch Zednik come up here. Bang! That's a blatant cross-check in the face. Adam Foote threw his gloves off and just grabbed Zednik, and I think he was trying to claw his eyeballs out at that point. Let's see what we got. Adam Oates is pretty concerned.
Now, the Colorado door is open in the penalty box as well. Nobody has gone in there yet for the Avs.
I'm going to bet 4 on Zednik and 2 on Foote.
3:19 to go in the overtime. Bob Hartley's Avs trying to remain undefeated. Adam Oates over there talking. He and Sakic representing their teams with the officials. Steve Walkom explaining, along with Dean Warren, the two referees in this game, what the calls are. Now, Zednik is coming out of the box. Nope, sorry. He was just getting his equipment. Well, maybe he,
well,
he started out twice.
He's threatening to come out. Yeah, baby, look at this.
I think he's out of the game.
Well, he's got to. Well, let's make with the calls here, gang.
There he goes. Zednik's heading to the dressing room. But whatever the call is, high sticking, cross check, take your pick. Question is how many minutes? So we have nobody in the penalty box now on either side.
Just as we predicted.
And they are explaining to the coaches what's happened here. No announcements have been made yet.
Explain to us, guys.
There's been nothing put up on the board either to indicate there's any advantage to either team. Adam Foote is still out there in the ice. He's standing by the Colorado bench. He hasn't gone anywhere.
This little wipe on the nose, clear off as much of the blood as possible and turn me loose. Remember, Adam Foote wore a visor last year in the playoffs after he was hit in the eye and opted over the offseason to take it off. That might have saved him that blow to the bridge of the nose, but not the kind of guy he is and not the kind of equipment he wants to use.
Faceoff is going to be at center with 3:19 to go in the overtime. This game tied at 3.
We're kind of still waiting too, aren't we?
No calls yet. Foote has gone into the bench, penalty box rather, and now Bulas will go over. Jan Bulas is in the penalty box serving whatever the calls were against Richard Zednik. There's Foote. 4 minutes up on the board against the Capitals.
Well, I know one thing. There are 4 Colorado Avs on the ice right now and 3 Washington Caps. And that's all we need to know.
So the extra time has been assessed against Zednik with 3:19 to go. But we still haven't. Now they've got 3 minutes up there for the power play.
I'm not sure I'm familiar with that.
No, and I'm not going to try. But I'll tell you, we got apparently we have a 3-minute power play, something I've not seen before.
You may never again.
And we haven't seen Patrick Roy ever win the most games of any goaltender either. We may see that here as well. So a power play, 4-on-3, overtime, 3 minutes to go. Down low, Bork, save Colvin. 2 chances for Bork to win this game. Cleared out. And now 2:50 in the game, 2:30 on the power play. 4, Colorado, offside. Everybody's quiet waiting for the PA announcer's announcement. He started and stopped. And,
well, he's kind of stuttering his way through it. So this is like pulling teeth, and we apologize, but we're at the mercy of the, right now, the PA system to find out what's going on. One more look at it, though. Here we go.
2 minutes for elbowing at 1:41. Colorado calls timeout.
Colorado's going to use their timeout here while you're watching the Zednik Foote affair. Zednik has already left the bench. He's gone into the dressing room. He's out of the game for whatever those calls were against him.
He may be with Elvis. He may have completely left the building. What we do know is Jan Bula sitting in there for Washington is completely disinterested in what's happening here because he ain't getting back in the game.
He knows it's done. He's done for the night. Lights out, literally, on Jan Bula. All right, here you go. Zednik got a game misconduct on the cross check.
Right.
And a 5-minute major.
Right.
Foote got an elbowing for 2.
Right.
So 2 from 5, 3. Is what we got up on the board for the power play.
Simple math.
There you go. Power play underway. Forsberg, they only need 1 to win this for Patrick Roy. Raymond Bork out there again. Sakic shot! And another Kolzig move to block that. Sakic turns it back on top to Raymond Bork. Bork to Sakic. Sakic in. Back to Bork. Bork doesn't wind up and take it. Will here. Shot! Score! Raymond Bullock, the goal! Patrick Waugh, the winningest netminder in National Hockey League history! Lennon and McCartney said, Bill, you know, it don't come easy.
Oh, this one sure didn't. Patrick Waugh knew that this would happen sooner or later. He would have preferred sooner, and he got sooner. Tough, though. Tough all the way. The Washington Caps dug their heels in, and it was finally the excellence on the power play, including a blast from the point from Ray Bourque that may have been tipped by Peter Forsberg that led to the victory in OT.
They have credited Forsberg with the goal, Raymond Bourque the assist. And Patrick Waugh came jumping out of the crease with his 448th win, now one ahead of Terry Sawchuk, his wife Michelle, his dad on hand for this game. Here's the game winner, and it is a power play goal in overtime.
Sakic back to Ray Bourque. Bourque over to the side to Hajduk, and in the blast. Peter Forsberg perfectly positioned. You got to know Ray Bourque was aiming right at him, and like he was shot out of a cannon. Patrick Waugh finally can bleed the sigh of relief as the winningest goaltender in NHL history.
On the ice, Elmore Gandy.
It's official. I'm with the winningest goaltender in NHL history. Patrick, you've won Stanley Cups, MVPs in the playoffs. How does this rate to it all?
Well, before we start, I promise my three children at home that I'll be the first one I talk to them. Hey, guys, I love you.
Congratulations. I'm sure they're real thrilled. You've got to be thrilled yourself. You've had your eyes set. Your victories mean so much. Wins, just personally, this record for you.
Well, it's fun. I mean, the guys deserve a lot of credit. I mean, the way we played since the beginning of the year, and it's been a lot of fun. And this year seems like everybody's ready to make a big commitment, and we're playing very well. I mean, it's fun now to be where I am, but the person who was ahead of me before deserved a lot of credit, and I have a lot of tough for him right now.
Next plateau, everybody looking at 500?
Well, right now we're going to have fun with this one and keep playing well, and our objective as a team is try to be well prepared for the playoff, and hopefully this time we could win this one for Ray.
Certain trophy for him and for you and the whole team in the spring.
Thank you very much.
All right, good luck, Patrick. Congratulations. Patrick Waugh, the winningest goaltender of all time.
Washington remains looking for their first win. Colorado remains undefeated. And Patrick Waugh takes the piece of history home, number 448. And the win came in overtime. It came after they had a 2-0 lead in the first, with Washington battling back to tie it, and then Washington took a 3-2 lead, and then finally in OT, he watched from the other end as Bourque's shot was deflected by Peter Forsberg.